it's going to be indescribable.
Unbelievable.
Motivated.
Enthusiastic.
Very emotional, so it is.
Anxious.
Indescribable.
How do you feel about the trip to South Africa in one word, Amy?
I feel like I'm changing lives.
Ecstatic.
Indescribable.
Anxious.
Excited.
Basically, today our objective is to try and clean up the streets of Blanco. We have rubbish all over the streets. We're trying to get it in the wheelbarrows and get it up to the dump. Get it done as quickly and as effectively as possible.
While we're doing this, the other part of our group are on up the hill and they're making food and then going around houses and giving it to the people who need the food. Without you,
my bones ache, my skin feels cold, and I'm getting so tired and so old. The anger swells in my guts, and I won't.
Basically, we're just waiting on the food to be cooked in the kitchen to do a food drop, while the other half of the team are out helping the community while cleaning. But while we're waiting, we're just helping a few locals clean out their garden, do the weeds and lift up rubbish and just brush it out for them.
Yeah, just waking up in the morning and to be well. Quite honest with you, I ain't really sleep well. You ever feel like your train of thought's been derailed? That's when you press on, lean in. Half the population just waiting to see me fail. Yeah, right, you better off trying to freeze hell. Some of us do it for the females, and others do it for the retail. What I do it for the kids, life through the time we're in on. Every time you fall, it's only making your chin strong.
Thumbs up, everybody, thumbs up.
And I'll be in your corner like Mick, baby, till the end. And when you hear the song from that.
Well, today we're split up into two groups. One group went and helped with the food run, and my group, we stayed and helped clean up the streets. Just the people that really can't clean it up themselves, just to help them out and lift stuff and bring it down to the dump.
And you should ever have your head down. 6'5", 220 pounds. Hailing for rock bottom, Loserville, nothing town. Textbook version of a kid going nowhere fast. And now I'm yelling, kiss my ass. It's gonna take a couple right hooks, a few left jabs, for you to recognize you really ain't got it bad. Until the referee rings the bell. Until both your eyes start to swell. Until the crowd goes home.
We're just doing the food drop, dropping some soup around to all the local houses to people who need fare, and just brought lots of kids with us because we love us.
Hi, Chris! Yeah!
Oh, you did! Oh,
yeah, everybody wave! Wave!
Okay, so today we're preparing for the food run and also the clinic as well. Basically, Stella is the lady here who prepares all the food, and all the young people will go down today and help feed the local people in Blanco. As you can see, so it's a stew type, curry stew, And Anna has served this before, and says the locals sort of love it.
Yeah, it's great for the people in the clinic to get a meal with their medication, because what often happens is they're coming down with an empty stomach and getting the medication, and then it's coming back up because they have a net. So if we can serve a meal with their medication, it means they get what they need, basically.
There's loads of nutrition as well, and there's loads of vegetables and potatoes and stuff. It looks really good. And how often do you do this, Anna? How often
is this? This is every Tuesday and Thursday. We go to the clinic and then feed the homes after. So, busy days.
The young people are actually waiting outside, and once this is prepared and ready to go, then we're going to break our way down to the clinic, and also we're going to go out and feed the people of Blanco.
Clinic now, and it's very touching because you're giving people food. We're back home, if we were to sit down and try to have people food, they laugh at it, and these people are very grateful and trying to give you stuff in return as well, and it's just touching. Happy to be there.
How much of stuff have you been doing, Skate? What have you been up to?
When they're handing out the food, I've just been sharing the dishes and they've just been saying they're so grateful for just a little bit of food. They're just saying thank you every day, give a bit of food.
Prefer to thank you is better, don't they?
And what was your thoughts this morning, making up day two in Blanco? What was your thoughts?
See, yesterday it was extremely hard because you're just getting into things and it was emotional, but the day you're getting up, you sort of have a thin hang of what you're going to be doing. But each day, as each day goes on, you can't wait to get started and you can't wait to do the hard work, because the smell in people's faces is just out of this world. It's phenomenal.
Like the day, just come in
and
get out of bed, just do something, because you know you're making people happy. Like, just put the smell on my face, just to set the sense.
Today we're doing the first day of our summer scheme at Redberry Farm. Curly and Alan are away to get the kids and bring them up to us. We're going to play games, frisbees, face painting, some teamwork and group work's also going to go on, and just have a real great day with them all and hopefully bring a wee smile to their face. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
Ha ha ha! Today we brought some of the kids down to the summer scheme from Blanco, and we had face painting activities, playing on the trampoline, kicking the football about, and they loved it. And I got close with some wee kid called AD, and all he done was run about and wanting to hug you and all that there, and I painted his face, and we got like some loaf chips and toasties, and they all loved it, so they did. And we got in the gallery and we went up the train, and we got on the train and I was sitting with wee AD and going around the train. It was brilliant, they all loved it, and it was good crack, so it was